Hello friends, how is going on? Thank you for your very nice response for my previous video, which was about the Airtel ADSL or the VDSL modem with 40 Mbps speed. And if you haven't looked at this video, you can check the link in the above annotations. So in today's video, I'm going to show you about Siti Broadband. As you know that since the day when the Jio launched, everybody is like in the race of providing the highest speed internet connection. So local cable net operators like Siti Broadband, or you can say Fastway, so they are also providing their cable net modems, as we can say, or we can call it as cable net internet connections, not the fiber one, because the fibers are underground and these fibers are not directly coming to our home, and we are getting the internet connections using the cables, so we can call it as a cable net. So here you can see the first look of the broadband modem, which looks quite similar like to the normal modems. WPS is shown on the above, there is a link light and there is a data download. I will explain all the things that which light is for which purpose. Here I'm going to explain the lights from the right to left. So first one is a power, which will, and all the lights are green in color here. So if this is on, then this is power connected, and the other link, which is like the down arrow, this is not a downstream scanning. It should be stable to show you that the downstream is logged. If the downstream is scanning, then it will show you the blinking. Next to it is a upstream ringing, and once it is done, then it is known as upstream log. The one which is like a circle above the eye is, it is a CM provisioning, like you are online when it is showing you green, like your device is online. The next link, your device is connected to the internet or not. If it is blinking, then data is in traffic. If it is off, no ETH device connected. And this Wi-Fi signal, everyone knows that the Wi-Fi is enabled, and if it is blinking, then the data is in traffic. And the WPS, the same thing, if it is blinking, you are pairing some WPS device. If it is like stable, then some WPS pairing is completed. Or if it is not blinking, then WPS is inactive. So simply there is a WPS button above all as well. So here, this comes with the vertical mount stand. And on the back, if you see, there are only few things. One is a power adapter, other is a LAN, single LAN. Yes, they are like providing sort of a, because it is even a single channel as well. But this doesn't mean that on a single channel we can provide multiple LANs. So there is a one reset port, and other is a RF where you are going to connect your cable wire. Have a quick look, as it comes in a very cheap cardboard packing. Nothing fancy over there. And as in the entire body, you can see there are a lot of the holes for the air passing, even to the downside sides everywhere. And it only comes with only two things. One is a power adapter and other is a LAN cable, LAN patch cord. And here these looks in the box, at how this looks in the box when we open. So this is what the box looks like. As you can see here, the model number is CBW209D1. And it is based on DOCSIS 2.0, which is actually a very old technology launched in 2001 for the cable net providers. It has some sort of the limitations, depends on your internet connection what you are using. Like maximum download speed it supports with single channel, as it comes with a single channel which is 38 MB and 27 MB of the up. If you are using 50 MB plus plans, then definitely in that case, I hope so that your cable net providers are providing you 3.0 capable DOCSIS routers, because they have 4 channels and each channel support 38 MB of the down and 27 MB of the up, which means like it is providing you 152 MB of the down with 108 MB of the up speed. So it also depends, because these come in more than 4 channels. And just only for your information, 3.1 is also there in the market, which supports up to 10 gig of the down speed and 1 gig of the up speed, which is based on QAM. So let's proceed further. So here is an interface which you can simply open by using local host URL, which is little different than the normal routers. Here you have to use 0.1. So once you open it, you can see this simple page where it shows you the router username and the password. And the router username and password is same like admin password. Initially, if you want to change, you can change it anytime. And you don't have to mess up with any particular available information here, because this is the information which is providing to you by your cable net provider. But yes, you can change your DHCP starting IP address, as here by default it is configured for 100 to 150, as they think that you are not going to connect more than 50 devices on it. And it also shows you active DHCP leases, that how many devices are connected over here. And the same way, if you check the WAN connection, we don't have to change any value because it is configured for the DHCP and it has its own MAC address. Now all the normal tabs, just only to show you what's inside, so if you are curious, so at least you will have an idea which type of the interface and which type of the options this router is providing. After this, I'm going to tell you how you can hide your modem on the network, which is very, very complicated in the case of this modem. I am going to make it easy for you. Here on this page, I'm going to show you, and here in the SSID, if you are looking at how you can make your network not visible over the Wi-Fi, simple, you have to select this closed option in the network type. And it is a very complicated option because no one can easily understand, and it is like different from the most common routers thing. It is not going to broadcast its SSID. After that, I'm going to show you a speed test. Now let's check the speed by using the speed test, which is showing right now it's like 5 point something MB on a 5 MBPS plan, where the upload speed is always between 1 and something. So right now some upstream is also working over there, so I can say that I'm getting like 256 KBPS less than the real provided upstream. I hope so this video provided you a very good overview about this modem and the technology which they are using to provide us this cable net. So I am trying to arrange the fastway modem. If that will be arranged, my next video will be on that. It depends. If you are using the city cable connection and you are using like 50 MBPS, 100 MBPS, please share your experience with me via the comments. Definitely I would be happy to know that how much speed and how good quality you are getting with your connections. And don't forget to like this video, and I hope you already subscribed to the channel. If not, please subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to click on the bell so that you will get notified whenever I will publish some video for you. Thank you. Signing off for today. Bye bye.